Chris Producing coming down to help out with this demo. I just want to just tell you a little bit about the butcher shop in general. We'll go over the specifics of what we're doing now in a few minutes, but for right now, it's just important for you guys to see that a true butcher shop is one that understands the utilization and the respect of an entire animal butchery, right? So what does that mean? That means that we bring in whole animals, we know how to break them down, and we know how to process each aspect of them so that we can utilize as much of that animal as humanly possible. That comes in the forms of pâtés, of sausages, of charcuterie, of many different kinds of roasts or steaks or whatever. The butcher shop's focus is to be open all the time for people so that they can always have access to this country. So when we say that we're open all the time, that means that we're open 7 days a week from 9 to 9. And it also means that if you guys don't see something in the case, it doesn't mean that we don't have it. It just means that we don't have it at that moment, or possibly it's not in the case and we don't have it. So we want to spawn a relationship between the customers, you guys, our guests, and our butchers to be able to facilitate you guys getting whatever it is that you need, want, or could ever desire. So it needs to be an open relationship. You guys should feel comfortable talking to us about whatever you need. And now that you guys know about the butcher shop, this is Sam Martin, our owner here.
Hi guys, thank you for showing up for our demo. I think this is like our fourth or fifth demo that we've been doing, and over the course of the last few months, the response has been great. We've done some cattle, we've done a front quarter, we've done a hind quarter, and we've done a couple of different pigs. And today we've been trying to do something a little differently. So usually we teach you how to butcher the animal, what goes into butchering, where the pieces of meat come from. And then when people leave, they say, well, that's great, I know what to do with it, but I know how to butcher it, but what do I do with the meat now? So at the same time, butchering, you have to take apart a lamb. We're going to be talking to you about the different cuts of the lamb and actually how you cook them. The obvious way you can tell the difference between lambs is really the size. All the Australian, New Zealand lamb that you see around, it's very good quality lamb, but it's a lot smaller than the domestic lamb. The reason being is because in Australia, the lamb grazes on grass from the time it's born to the time it dies, so slaughter. And in the United States, in Colorado, because it's the domestic lamb, they graze on grass and they're finished on grains usually. So the grains really make it adheres to the meat, bulks up the size of the lamb over the last, 60, 90 years, whatever it is, depending on who's growing it. So what we're doing is you can start taking apart. Aaron's going to take apart the lamb right now. He's going to start by taking off the back legs. So the back legs and shank will come off right now. And what a great part of the lamb. Everybody knows about the lamb chops and the lamb loin, but a real forgotten part of the lamb is what, and things is the leg of the lamb and the shanks of the lamb, right? In Europe, the shanks are great. So all those over there are lamb shanks. And we sell a lot of lamb shanks. And it's such an easy, it's cost effective, first of all, because everybody's paying the big bucks for their lamb chops, right? The longer you need to marinate it for, right? Like, to marinate this leg of lamb for 3-4 hours, it wouldn't do anything really, 6 hours to overnight for sure on the bigger pieces of meat. So, one of my favorite ways to do leg of lamb is take the boneless leg of lamb and leave it flat before you roll it and toss it into a beautiful marinade.
Red wine, some chopped garlic, some parsley. Very simple. It could be as simple or as complicated as you want it to be. So what we like is having the natural flavor of the lamb shine through it. And here's your version. We're working with such a great, high-quality piece of meat. You don't have to do much to it. I mean, it really is that simple. A little bit of flavoring, a little bit of seasoning, that's it. Then that time and patience is all it takes. So you can you smell this?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God, yeah.
That helped out.
I'll show you a great chop with this a little later on. But right now I'm going to focus on breaking this down into 2 pieces. And that's a shoulder chop that Aaron's talking about. It looks like a ribeye with a bone in the center, almost like a ham bone in the chop, and great piece of lamb that
another very inexpensive cut of lamb that you can throw on your barbecue. There, and here's the loin. That's the tail of the loin, and that's the thick part of the loin. It gets thicker just like anywhere else.
Right. And then we've also got the rib stuff here. Now when you guys come in, we try to have as much stuff ready for you guys as possible, but we also want to make sure that we can cater it specifically to what you want. So I've taken the chine bone off of here, which is this bone right here, and now the chops are ready as a rack. Just be tied and thrown in the oven and ready to go.
Over the oil, and I refreshed it.
Yeah. So you can see what Frank's doing here, right? And you can put whatever you want in there. Again, carrots. If you like fennel, you can put fennel. Frank just added golden raisins. So
I love the sweetness going in there. Right?
I think that's a really nice touch when you're braising lamb shanks, just to throw a little sweetness in there. Not a sugar sweetness, but a
natural sweetness.
Dried cranberries, golden raisins, prunes, dates, currants, things like that work really, really well on the side of lamb, next to lamb. So
now that I got it all caramelized, the flavors have come together. I added some salt and pepper to really control the natural juices. And I'm going to add our chicken stock. You can add white wine at this point, red wine at this point. If you add any more alcohol at this point, we want to reduce that down. We want to cook the alcohol out of it, yet still retain the flavor of it, so it's not winey. So I didn't add any because I want a natural, very, very simple, sweet flavor to it. And the beef broth, we're just going to bring that up to a boil. As soon as that comes up to a boil, I'm going to add the lamb into it, we're going to cover it up, and we're going to pop it in the oven. So you guys have to wait an hour and a half. Or 2 hours. Have some cocktails.
No problem.
Some down that's coming out of the oven right now, I believe.
Yes.
But yeah, it's, you know, it depends. It's lamb shanks. It's a braising thing that when you're cooking it, you know, it breaks in an hour and a half. Sometimes it's an hour and a half, and then the next time I do it, it's an hour and 50 minutes, right? It really depends on that lamb, on its actual muscle structure, just like every other human being. Some people are very muscular, and some people are not so muscular. So it's the same thing with the lambs when they're natural like that. So there's approximately an hour and a half, but it doesn't eat an hour and a half, then your lamb is done, you know? It might take 2 hours even. 350 degrees. You want to get the lamb on the inside temperature. When braising, it's a little different.
Yeah.
Because braising, you need to cook it for so long where the meat's falling off the bone, right?
Yeah,
but let's say.
But additionally, your oven's not working as hard and it's going to penetrate the meat. So the heat is going to penetrate a lot easier. And you'll get a lot more of an even cook throughout the entire roast or beef or leg of lamb. So you see that? I got a nice sear on that. Just trying to get up here so we can get on the other side. Super quick. And again, like Seth said, you could do this a day in advance, 2 days in advance to this point. Trust it.
It'll last longer in your fridge too if we do that.
Okay, so
we're gonna move to Frank. He's gonna finish coating over here in the lamb chop to show you.
So you can see that it's got a beautiful sear on the outside, on the bottom, and on the back side. And if you notice, I took particular care of not burning the bones. Right? I didn't really allow the bones to hit the bottom. I kind of did. Chop them up a little bit on the end. I just like how pretty it looks. Without them getting charred. So it's a little hot, so I'm going to hold it for a little bit.
You know what we do a lot of the time is we actually wrap the bones in foil. So we'll take a piece of aluminum foil and we'll just wrap them around the bones before we put it in the oven. This way, when the lamb or the pork chop or whatever chop it is comes out of the oven, you take the foil off and the bones are so nice and clean and white versus burnt or charred or whatever.
Smells like springtime.
Yeah, so that's just our beautiful, you know, you get all the fresh herbs, everybody loves mint with lamb, and right? And now we're just going to...
just kind of driving it into the breadcrumbs a little bit, and then sprinkling on top and squeezing it and patting it on.
Right, so now that we go into an oven at like 350 degrees, 375 degrees for, like Frank said, about 10 minutes, 8 minutes. Again, if you have a thermometer, and if it's larger than that, you can take an internal temperature of the thermometer at like 130, and you're at the rare side. You know, again, I keep talking about nose detail, so this is the neck, right? One of my favorite pieces. So we don't have cheeks because we don't get the
heads,
so we don't really find it. If we need a lamb cheeks, we would order a lamb head on. But great braising, super, super flavorful. Throw this in a pot of lentils or something like that, or vegetables, and braise it for a couple hours. And this meat is just so tender and so delicious, the neck meat. So again, amazing meat here.
See how clean and beautiful the bone is. It's actually falling off the bone a little bit.
Just look. Right? I mean, it's just
shredding right off.
Oh my gosh, good too. So that's the same. You know, we have all these recipes too, these simple ones, that you can doctor yourself, right? So you can now look at them and add your own touches. So we got copies up around here somewhere that you can take with you as well. But they're going to portion out some of the lamb shank, and you can see what it tastes like. You can come around here if you like. You can continue to ask questions. But our lamb demo is sort of done.
Thank you.